Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So our today's topic is Karatsuba multiplication. Before understanding that what is Karatsuba multiplication, let us understand why we need Karatsuba multiplication. So till yet we have the general multiplication where the time complexity of multiplying two numbers is big of n square. Okay, so we can reduce the time complexity with the help of Karatsuba multiplication. So I will explain what is Karatsuba multiplication with the help of two numbers, with the help of example itself. Okay, so there are so many steps in doing the Karatsuba multiplication. So step number one, or we can say the rule number one, let's say we have these two numbers for which we have to multiply. The rule number one says that it only works on even digit numbers. Okay, even number of digits only. So let's say we have a number like 432 and it has odd number of digits, or it only has three digits here. So we have to add zero ahead of it to make it an even number of digit number. Okay, so now here in this case, the number of digits in this number is 4, and similarly for this, it's 4. That's okay. The first step is we have to divide this number in two half. So 4 half will be 2. So basically, the A will be expressed like this, and B will be expressed like this. Now, from here, I can compute that my A higher will be 54 and A lower will be 32 because I have divided the A number into complete halves. And similarly, my B higher will be 16 and B lower will be 78. Now, step 2 is I have to calculate these three variables, C0, C1 and C2. C0 is multiplication of A lower into B lower. This A lower into B lower, and the result is 2496. Similarly, C1 is a multiplication of A higher into B higher, these two higher numbers, and it is 864. And C2, it is a multiplication of when we add these two numbers and add these two numbers and multiply them and subtract C0 and C1 values from it. That's how we get the C2 value. Okay, so now our final result of multiplication, when we multiply these two numbers, final result of multiplication will be C1, this is a general equation up here, C1 into 10 to the power n plus C2 into 10 to the power n by 2 plus C0. Earlier our n was 4. So substituting on all these value in this equation, we got this result, and this is our final multiplication solution. So here we can see that in general multiplication, like say when I'm multiplying these two numbers, here each number will be multiplied with every 4 digits. Okay, each of these 4 digits. So basically total computations will be 16. Total multiplications will be 16. But here in this case, I can see that total number of multiplications are only 3. Here only one multiplication is taking place in C0, one in C1 and one in C2 it only. When 3 multiplications are taking place, which reduces a lot of computations and hence the time complexity, because the system takes less time in calculating subtraction and addition, and it takes more time in division, modulus and multiplication stuff. So the time complexity by Karatsuba is just big of n raised to power 1.5. So that's why we use Karatsuba multiplication, because it may seem very, very, very normal in the case of smaller numbers that the difference between n square and n 0.5 is not that big. But in the case of larger numbers, very, very large numbers, this difference really matters a lot. Okay, and it basically make the computation very, very easy too. That's why we use Karatsuba, and it's guided to do that way. So thank you guys.